Juba-Nimule Road was completed on the 12th September 2012 and handed over by the United States Agency for International Development to the government of South Sudan. The road connecting South Sudan to East Africa via Uganda as its delivery of commercial goods and the movement of people from and to the country. The road has halved the traveling time from previous 6 hours to now 3 hours. But today, a bit more than a year since the opening, the road's tarmac surface has plenty of potholes. This raises concern among many South Sudanese citizens who have enjoyed the benefits of the road. Mama Hirin, one of the entrepreneur women at the Juba's custom market, explained how expensive goods were before the road was opened.
The road for Nimule, when it is affected by floods, we don't receive goods the way we are supposed to receive it. And the little ones that enter, they are at a very high demand. We the business people, we find it so hard to buy it what? At a very expensive price. People complain, our community surrounding us, they like cheap things, eh?
Since the road was open and the flow of goods were easier, prices went down. As Mama Christine, another businesswoman at Juba's custom market, explains.
Zaman alisa masalade kana jet biga gali lakin asa sala tomato mbese biga be 50 be 70 chukamba kilo wae be ashara jine.
The road's condition is deteriorating day by day, and many fear another price hike and a delay in delivery of essential goods. Mama Irene, deeply concerned about the road's condition, suggests the government of South Sudan should construct another highway.
I'm advising the government of South Sudan to repair the road of Kaya. That is the only advice I can give to the government of South Sudan.
The question in the minds of many South Sudanese is, who is supposed to maintain the Juba-Nimule Road? Is it the government or the contracted companies? Whoever is responsible, quick action is required before the condition of this essential lifeline deteriorates further. For the Niles, I am Simon Bingo.